Hey guys, this is the final campaign that I will create a walkthrough on expert mode for it. I will not create any walkthrough for the cold stream campaign because I only played it a few times and then I never played it after that. So I'm not really good at that campaign. That's why I'm not going to be able to create any walkthrough about it. It's always a good idea that you start with the machine gun. Forget the shotgun because you will have to do a lot more medium to long range shooting than close quarter shooting. Especially for example when you have a special infected, you want to, like when you see them coming in from far away, you want to reduce as much health as possible from them before they come close to you. So that when they come close to you and they try to make any attack, it will be too late for them. Especially for example when you're talking about charger and you see him coming from far away, you know, and you're having the pump shotgun or the chrome shotgun, you know, it will be too difficult to deal with him when he come close. Okay guys, here where I'm sitting in right now guys, this is a very good area to defend yourself from any horde that is coming from the front, because they will all be coming from one direction. And that direction is too small that it will be too easy for you to just keep pushing them away from you, and then at the same time you will keep shooting at them. Now if the horde also came from the back, the bots will be able to take care of them, while you can easily take care of the horde that is coming from the front, because again they are all coming from a very small direction, very small area. They're coming from a very small area, which make it too easy for you to deal with them. So I'm just letting you know, in case if you get horde, make sure you stay there. Do not move forward and stay in the middle, because they will surround you from everywhere if you do that. And it will not hurt if you come here to get more ammo for yourself, because you know you still have to do a lot more shooting before the next machine gun that you will be able to get. And here guys, we will have horde coming in soon. I was trying actually to go inside the building, but there was a hunter inside there. I couldn't go in because there was a hunter in the front and there were also some zombies on the right, on the left side. So if I just go to the hunter, I will be attacked from the left. Now we have the horde coming in. I was actually trying to go inside the room so that we do not lose any health. We can see here Rochelle already lost a lot of health. She was hit so many times and now she's down, because we have here a charger as well coming. Even though what happened here, we lost a lot of health, but trust me, it's much better than if you are sitting in a wide open area where you have nothing to cover you. Here we have, at least there was a wall that was covering us. You see the wall on the right side, that wall, it prevented the zombies from coming from one of the directions. Remember, if you're dealing if you have horde and they are coming to you from four different directions, like the front, the back, the left and the right, it will be much more difficult than if you have horde coming in from three directions only. Like in our case, where the horde came in, they were coming from three directions: the behind us, front of us and the left side. Which of course we will still lose health because it's still very difficult to deal with them, but it's much harder if you are going to sit in a wide open area and you have the zombies are coming from all directions. And guys, you can always try it yourself. If you don't think that this is true, you can always try it. Try to resist the horde in a wide open area where they will surround you from everywhere, and try to resist them when you have a wall behind you that protect you from the back, and you will see the huge difference between them. Now the coming area is one of the most difficult areas in this level, because you have car alarm and you have also a lot of time you have horde coming in and you have a lot of zombies scattered all over around the car. Now when you enter this room, just make sure before you get in, make sure you clear any zombie that is running your way, and then after they stop running your way, make sure you look to your sides, to the left, to the right, to make sure that there is nothing will be attacking you from the sides. Because you do not want any surprises, you know, you do not want to get yourself a punch in the face as soon as you get in and lose 20% of your health. Now we have here a smoker in the back. I can hear he's jumping down, so I'm going for him to kill him. And here, as soon as I go to the room, you see I'm looking here, because a lot of time these zombies that are on the sides, they will actually run in front of you and then give you a punch in the face. It will be so fast, you know, like a lot of time it happens so fast that you will not have time to push them away from you before they give you the punch. Now, when you come out here, make sure you also clear the area here in the back. Do not just rush to the safe room. If you do that, the game actually can end right here, because the zombies will surround you from everywhere, you and the bots. And here we have a horde coming in. That's why I pulled myself back, so that I can give myself some cover. It's still not very safe, but it's much better than sitting outside. I was actually was trying to get inside the room, but I saw the zombies are coming in, so I have to stay here, because I also have to help the bots in here. It will be difficult for the bots to get inside with me, because they will be busy dealing with the horde that is attacking them from the front. That's why I did not want to leave them. I want to stay here, and I want to help them out in this area. I don't want to get in by myself. You can see here also that Coach is the one that took most of the beating. Make sure you just keep sitting in the back and help them. Don't get close, because you do not want the zombies to come in from this side here and start attacking you. So that's why I'm sitting in the back and I keep helping him from the back, so that nothing will come after me. And here we have a boomer, so I shot him through the wall. Of course, you cannot just shoot from any part of the wall. If you want the bullets to go through the wall, you have to shoot from at the very end of the wall, as I did. But if you shoot in the middle of the wall, I don't think it's going to work out. And that's it for this video, guys. I hope that you enjoyed it. And please, guys, don't forget to give a good rating for this video if you think it will help you out to finish this level on expert. And you can also come to my channel here. You can see my YouTube channel. This is the link for it. You can come for more videos.